We would like to welcome students, staff, parents, and family to the Marine City High School's 2022 Homecoming Assembly. At this time, we're going to introduce our 2022 Homecoming Court. Our freshman princess is Jacqueline Northrup, daughter of Andrea Gaston. She has an older brother, Noah, and twin sister, Audrey. Jacqueline is involved in varsity swim and travel softball. Her future plans are to be a nurse at Detroit Medical Center or be in the police force. In her free time, Jacqueline likes to clean, work out, hang with friends, and make jokes with her favorite teacher, Mr. DeHunt. This month, Jacqueline is celebrating 9 years of being cancer-free. Her freshman prince is Donnie Cartwright, son of Donnie Cartwright Sr., and his stepmom, Caitlin Ballard. He has a brother, Colin. Donnie is involved in Mariner football. His future plans are to play college football. And when Donnie's not at school, he enjoys working out, playing football, basketball, and spending time with his family. Next, our sophomore princess is Tia DeWalls. She is the daughter of Tony and Tracy DeWalls. She has a sister, Tavery. Tia is involved in Mariner soccer and travel soccer. Her future plans are to graduate from Marine City High School and further her education, studying medicine, and start a career in healthcare. In Tia's free time, she likes spending time with her family and friends. Our sophomore prince is Easton Laboon. Easton is the son of Jesse and Courtney Laboon. Easton has an older sister, Mackenzie, older brother, Blake, and a dog named Chewy. Easton is involved in Mariner football, basketball, and baseball. His future plans are to become a mechanical engineer. And in his free time, Easton likes to play video games and hang out with his friends. Now walking down is our junior princess, Jade Blanchard. Jade is the daughter of Adam and Holly Blanchard. She has an older brother, Jacob, and a younger sister, Aubrey. Jade is the captain of the varsity volleyball team and a 3-year varsity athlete for softball, basketball, and volleyball. She coaches the 5th and 6th graders in a travel basketball program and is also the junior class treasurer of student government and a member of National Honor Society. Jade's future plans are to attend college to become an orthodontist and hopes to continue her athletic career at the college level. Jade enjoys hanging out with friends and traveling with her family. Our junior prince is Blake Laboon. Blake is the son of Jesse and Courtney Laboon. He has an older sister, Mackenzie, a younger brother, Easton, and a dog named Chewy. Blake is involved in tennis, swim, and track. After graduation, Blake has big plans. He's gonna move to Alaska to evacuate UFO crash sites. He would also like everyone to know that he is a full-time Star Wars nerd, and he also enjoys building Legos. That is Blake Laboon. Our first female senior court representative is Michaela Sands. She is the daughter of Stephen and Heather Sands. Michaela is involved in girls swim, Mariner drama, choir, and student government. Her future plans are to go to a 4-year university to become an elementary school teacher. When Michaela isn't at school, she enjoys hanging out with her friends, boyfriend, and family. Our first senior male representative is Andrew Rickle. Andrew is the son of Michael and Julie Rickle. He has an older brother, Christian. After Andrew graduates, he plans on going to a college or university and hopes to find what sparks his interest. In his free time, Andrew likes to hang out with his friends, family, and his girlfriend. Walking down next is our second female senior representative, Ashley Tranchmontaine. Ashley is the daughter of Bill and Chris Tranchmontaine. She has two sisters, Bailey and Brianna. Ashley is involved in student government, National Honor Society, and softball. After high school, Ashley is planning on attending Saginaw Valley State University and pursuing a career in teaching. In her free time, she likes to watch TV and hang out with her friends and family. Ashley is also celebrating her 13th year being cancer-free. Our second senior male representative is Connor Mason. Connor is the son of Emily Mason. He has two older brothers, Bryce and Tanner. Connor is also involved in Mariner football, coaching flag football, and powerlifting. After high school, he plans on attending the University of Northwestern Ohio and get his bachelor's degree in automotive technology. He also plans on getting into real estate and opening his own business. And now for our third set of senior representatives. First, Lindsay Gerard. Lindsay is the daughter of Jason and Joyce Gerard. She is a level 10 gymnast at Hunt's Gymnastics. She is also a member of the Mariner Marching Band as a trumpet section leader. Lindsay is a member of National Honor Society and a state champion in long jump. Lindsay plans on attending college to be a vet and specialize in horses and be on the college gymnastics team. In her free time, she enjoys playing her trumpet, being crafty and painting, hanging out with friends, riding horses, and of course, spending time with Brendan. Speaking of Brendan, our last senior male representative is Brendan Gray, son of Mark and Jody Gray. He has two sisters, Brianna and Brooklyn. Brendan is involved in track during the spring and he runs sprints, long jump, and plans on trying pole vault this year. After high school, he plans on getting certified in personal training and nutrition. He would like to learn about business to eventually open a gym and health facility. In Brendan's free time, he enjoys golfing, camping, hanging out with friends, working and working out. Parents, families, and friends, at this time, on behalf of Marine City High School, I would like to announce the 2022 Homecoming King and Queen. Will the Homecoming King and Queen please step forward as I read your name? This year's Homecoming King is Connor Mason. And this year's 2022 Homecoming Queen is Ashley Tranchmontaine. Crowning our 2022 Homecoming King and Queen is Marine City High School's Principal Sherry Becker and Assistant Principal Chris Reinhardt. Crowning the senior representatives is Student Government President Jacob Blanchard and Student Government Advisor Amanda Deitch. Congratulations to our King and Queen and all of our representatives.
Welcome back. Second half on tap. Mariners about ready to take the kickoff here. Up 12-8 against Clintondale.
Yeah, Craig, pretty low scoring game, but we didn't expect here between these two teams.
Couple mistakes. And
yeah, couple costly mistakes. Untimely.
Here we go. Craig Zimmerman, Jesse Laboon, Friday night. 42 degrees here. A little warm in the booth, but.
Kids at halftime on homecoming were a little bit chilly.
Yeah. Congratulations to all the homecoming queen in court. Pass play here on the return. Who's got it? Near side.
Just got to get up here. And
Ruffino, 40, 45, taken down at about the 46-yard line.
The play we've seen quite a bit of this year, Craig. Nice. And, you know, I think it's only maybe come to light the last year or two, you know. Yeah. You get used to these teams not kicking deep to your starboard. So right. Marine City being as innovative as they are.
Mirror offense
throw back
on the field from the 47-yard line, short field. Ruffino the wide to the left. I'm sorry, Ruffino on a run across the 50 to the other 45. Pick up about 8 on the play.
Another just big hole there for him to run through from that offensive line.
That was Atkinson far to the right that time. Second and 2. Maluski comes in. Ruffino comes off.
Left guard Andrew Rickle and left tackle Griffin Schulte, along with the center Alex Tigert, giving Ruffino a little room to run there.
Two wideouts near side. Two-man backfield for the Mariners, Maluski and Muscat. Pass play caught by Parker Atkinson, 40. Still going, out of bounds at about the 40. He'll pick up a first down and a couple more.
Yeah, defender just got a hold of his foot there, you know, trying to get that ball out in space to Parker and let him just basically usually has one man to beat, and normally he can do that and put quite a few yards up for the Mariners.
First and 10, 40, near side hash mark. keeper by the quarterback up the gut to about the 30. Pickup of close to 10. They're going to give him about 9, I think.
Boy, just yeah. close to spinal.
Heslip comes off. Lincoln Osterling comes on. Second and 2, game 8. Oh, nice job. Melisky gets across for a first down across the 30 to about the 28-yard line.
Good job by Lincoln Osterling
yep.
coming in there. I don't know if he saw something in audible, but change of formation there. And again, can't say it enough, that offensive line just giving Melisky a hole to get up yep. and get that first down.
Ball spotted at the 26 near side hash mark. Hansen goes far left along with Letson. Lincoln Osterling under center. Muscat up to the 20, inside the 20 to about the 18, close to a first down. Big pickup on first down, will be 8, maybe 9.
Yeah, Mariners doing a good job just getting some larger yardage plays here. Not giving themselves that, you know, shoot yourself in the foot, 3rd and 8.
Atkinson goes far left. Two-man backfield, Malewski and Muscat. This time, oh, got number 7. That's Connor Lang, caught behind the line of scrimmage, loss of a yard, bring up 3rd and maybe loss of a couple, 3rd and 5.
Yeah, the time on that exchange just didn't quite look right. I don't know if
right.
maybe he was supposed to take a fake and the ball ended up in his stomach and he just ended up taking it, so good effort. But.
Jeffrey Heslip checks back in. We'll call it 3rd and 5 from the 20. Two wideouts right. First guy, Muscat. First down, spins.
Real close yep. to a first down.
Yep, he's got it.
Good job. Well, he leaps over that defender. He's in the point. He's in the end zone for 6 points.
First and 10, ball spotted at the, 17-yard line. Pass play, throws, caught, Muscat, down to about the 14.
Boy, and back, that secondary, that safety just gave Parker a little bump there. He was wide open there in the back of the end zone.
Give him 2 on the play, 2nd and 8. Letson and Atkinson left. Hand off Malewski, left side of the line, gets a couple. Inside to about the 10, maybe the 9. Gonna spot him right at the 10, bring up 3rd and 4. Checking back in, Kyle Rickert.
Well, the Mariners approaching that 4-minute mark here, have all the possession here in the second half so far.
Muscat, Malewski in the backfield. Extra blocker left side. Oh, Muscat inside. Gets a first down, I believe. No, they're going to say he's a little short. Fourth and less than a yard, it looks
yeah.
like.
I thought he had forward progress yeah. over the 5-yard line.
Looked like it to me.
He was hit pretty good by that, I think it was a safety coming up.
They're going to call 4th and 1 from the 6. Got it this time. Malewski's going to score from 6 yards out. Cameron Malewski, and another great job by the Mariner offensive lineman putting a hole there for
yeah,
Cameron.
Once he got to the offensive yeah. line, he just had to navigate around a couple of defensive backs, and he was in there for 6. Extra 11 play drive
point
there.
Is good. Extra point, Brooklyn Zuziak makes it 19-8, Mariners by 11. It's what the doctor ordered.
That's what you want. You know, you did an excellent job. You almost ate up 5 minutes off the clock coming out of halftime. You put some points on the board and just try to open that lead up a little bit.
Talked about the momentum in the first half. You know, talked about the Dragons dominating the first quarter. And they dominated a good percentage of the second quarter from the standpoint of points. Mariners did exactly what you would want to do. Come out, great drive, put seven on the board.
11 play, almost a five-minute drive.
Ethan Haver kicks, picked up around the 12. This time it's Bursey. Off the right side, going to be near midfield.
Got a flag on the far side of the field well after the players were out of bounds.
There is a flag on the play.
Unsportsmanlike on somebody. If I had to guess, it's going to be on the Dragons.
Dead ball. Personal foul. A kickoff. Yep.
15-yarder against Mariners.
Uncharacteristic. I don't know what happened on the sideline there. But.
So Dragons will get good field position right at the 39-yard line, far side hash mark. Got three wideouts right, one to the left. Keys from the shotgun. Hardnett next to him. Points off Hardnett right side. Gets about 2 yards on the play. Taken down by a whole host of Mariners. Give him 2 second and eight from the 37. Henry near side, far side is Presley. As Bursey joins Henry on the left side, Thompson doesn't know where he's going. He's going to the left side now. Trips to the left. Keys gonna keep her. Try to sweep, he's got speed. Runs out of bounds at about the Does he pick a yard up? Not quite.
He's going to mark him right about the 35.
Now, I would guess to say that's about the third time he's ran that play tonight, mm-hmm. maybe fourth time, but he runs out of bounds when there wasn't a lot of traffic there.
Yeah, I agree. It's almost like he's got too much momentum going to the side.
I mean,
you can easily turn get up another two or three yards.
Yeah. Easy. It's like he doesn't want to get hit. Third and a long six, they're saying. Near side hash mark. They're going to try to kill the clock again. A little different story when you're down, though, you know. It's
yeah, like I said, I don't think they're trying to kill the clock. I just think that's how they operate their offense. Saw the same thing with the JV last night.
Yep. Two right, two left. Calling an audible, it sounds like. Keys from the gun. Hands off. Left side, not much, a couple yards.
58, Connor Fournier was able to hop on his back when he went by. Another couple of Marine City defensive linemen were able to stand him up there a little bit.
Fourth and five from the 34-yard line.
Evan Jones, Cole O'Croy in on the tackle for the Mariners.
Presley, Thompson, and Bursey to the right. To the left this time is Henry. Pass play, no, incomplete. Mariners will take over on downs.
Had a little screen pass yep. there, just wasn't able to bring the ball in out there.
Mariners tipped it. Pretty good showing by the football team on the homecoming court.
Yeah, it sure was. Congratulations to Connor Mason, yep. one
He's king.
Ashley Transmontane was the queen.
Andrew Rickle was out there as well as a prince, I guess, right?
Correct.
As did the Laboons had two showings on that.
They
huh?
sure did, yeah. Blake and Easton represented well, even in their respective classes.
Who wrote up that?
They wrote their own.
Yeah, exactly.
They wrote their
I
own.
Could tell who wrote it.
And they wrote it and says, can I put that? So you put whatever you want. That was quite comical.
First and 10 from the 34.
Oh, he's look at
Heslip's got him.
He's
stride. Parker Atkinson. 66-yard touchdown play from Heslip to Atkinson will make the highlight film.
Just an excellent thrown ball by Jeffrey. And you've seen that throughout the course of the game here. You know, Parker gets out there 8 or 10 yards, and then he just starts to pull away from his defender. But Jeffrey did a great job of leading him. And Parker didn't have to slow down whatsoever. He just caught
that.
Look at right in stride.
Going to beat by about 7 yards. Point after. We're missing somebody. Noah Northrup. Lineman. Cooper Letson to hold. Extra point is good. Ethan Haver for this one. 25-8 Mariners. It's all Mariners in the third quarter here. 26-8. So as you can see there, 5:26 left in the third. Mariner time of possession. The first drive was a pretty good, what, 4.5 minute drive or so?
It was over. Yeah, five. Yeah.
5 minute drive, and this one here in about 10 seconds.
Put a little bit more distance between them and the Dragons.
Ethan Haver to kick. Deep for Clintondale. Bercy and Henry lined up at about the 15-yard line. Deep. Bercy right side. Taken down about the 33-yard line.
Cole LaCroix, number 51 on the tackle.
Started at 46 degrees down to 41. Looks like 40 to 38 maybe. A little chilly out there. Well, you know, it's October, so.
Happy it's not raining, right?
Yes, for sure. Henry along with Thompson comes out near side. One to the right. Hand off this time to Harnett. Racing along the sidelines, picks up about 14 or 15. So it'll be first and 10, ball spotted at the 47-yard line. Got two wideouts right, one left. Shane Keats from the gun. Hands off quickly to Harnett.
Oh, swallowed up deep in the backfield that time.
Loss of about 4 on the play. Mariners read that one well. Evan Jones on the stop.
Jeremy Westrick back there quick, too, from that right side of the line. Defensive end position.
Sick 14 from the 43-yard line. Bercy and Henry come near side. Far side. Can't get the number. Keys and Harnett in the backfield. Pass play, throws it up, caught, number 5.
That big tight end.
Yep. Presley picks up about 12 on the play. Going to bring up a third and three, something like that.
I'm surprised that's the first. It's got to be one of the first completed passes they made to that kid tonight. He just stands.
Other than that touchdown.
Yeah, other than the touchdown. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, they threw into coverage that time, and he was just able to go up and grab that ball.
Third and two from the 45. Far side hash mark. Mariners in their home orange tonight. Started off a little skittish early and poured it on in the third. Keeper, tripped up. Got him dancing in the background.
They
didn't
sure
they?
Did.
Didn't know where to go.
Number 8, Justin Harnett with the keeper.
Harnett, direct snap, loss of about 3. Bring up a 4th and 5, 4th and 6. I don't think they're going to punt. Even if they line up and punt, I wouldn't take them as a punt.
Trent telling him, hey, if he throws a pass here.
It does punt. High, short. Takes a Mariner bounce. Let it go. Picks it up. Whoa. Who picked it up?
84.
Yeah. Colin Gabler.
Yeah. Saw he had like 2 people. Everybody
right.
else
he didn't
well
have much
past
to beat.
Him. No, he didn't.
No, didn't have much to beat there. Mariners will take over 1st and 10 from the 48-yard line for their third possession of the third quarter.
Colin wanted to get himself some offensive yards and points.
Two wideouts left, Letson and Atkinson. Up the left side, Ruffino. Give him about 10.
Good hard run.
Saying 10-yard pickup, first down. Now, these officials tonight have sort of, I'll say, been in the background. Haven't really called a ton.
No.
You know, sort of don't know they're there, you know.
Right. I think there are some things they're letting go.
I'd say it's a fairly well-officiated game. Ruffino gets back line of scrimmage maybe a little bit more. But there's not a lot of – this crew here seems to have – they're in command.
Yeah, and not making themselves the center of attention,
yeah,
which we've
exactly.
seen
yep.
in past games.
Atkinson to the left, 2nd and 9. Throws, caught by Atkinson, first down inside the 30 to 25, run out of bounds at the 24. They're looking for a penalty there.
Flag, he's 5 like yards out of bounds and still whipped to the ground.
First and 10, Marine City from the 24-yard line on a pass from Heslop to Parker Atkinson.
Lutzen over there advocating. He wants to talk to the head official. That is, you do put some kids at risk there when you start letting that kind of stuff go on
right.
outside of bounds. And Lutzen is not happy right now.
Time for station identification. CTV6, Marine City, St. Clair. Could even go to a sponsor if they wanted. Or not.
North Star Bank, your local community bank serving St. Clair, Sadlack, Huron, and Washtenaw counties. When you need a local community bank for home loans, checking, savings, and other banking needs, North Star Bank is the community bank that you want to deal with. The bank that will take care of all.
The 24-yard line, far side hash mark. Official giving him the go-ahead. Here we go. Three-man backfield for the Mariners. Ruffino gets to the edge, 20, 18, maybe 17.
Nice job, a little stiff arm there. Good job getting out wide outside, picking up additional yardage.
you look at that play there compared to what their back did on theirs as far as running out. I mean, he's picking up 2-3 yards more every play like that.
Correct, yeah.
Pickup of 6 on the play, 2nd and 4 from the 18. Atkinson left, 3-man backfield. 1st guy through Muscat. Down about a yard, couple yards. Going to bring up a 3rd and 2. 3rd and 2.
About a 1 second difference between the play clock and the score clock. So if the Mariners choose to, they would be able to run this clock out and head into the fourth quarter.
Kyle Rickard checks in. Maluski and Muska in the backfield.
Always got him.
Pass play, caught.
Get
inside,
in there.
Touchdown, Marine City. Kellen Gabler from 16 yards out. Heslip to Gabler. Puts the Mariners on top, 32-8. As Ella Hensley goes out for the point after. Cooper Letson, the holder.
Point is good by Ella.
Third quarter, all Mariners.
Sure was. Yeah, we'll have a chance to go back and see that replay, but that was basically set up by, you know, the wideouts running deep routes and just getting the rest of that Clintondale secondary sucked back into the end zone. Left Colin Gabler open there in the flat. Just make the reception, turn upfield, and get to that pylon, which is exactly what he did.
Ethan Haber to kick. Bercy and Henry deep for the Dragons. Haver gets some air under it. Bercy far side. Taken down at about the 38-yard line. 1st and 10 Dragons. There, third quarter in the books. A little more comfortable for the hometown team.
They've got drink specials every day. Rooms upstairs if you want to stay. If you love music, hear it play at the good old Murphy Inn. At the good old Murphy Inn.
Looking for a great spot to enjoy lunch or dinner with fantastic daily food and happy hour specials? Look no further than the Murphy Inn in St. Clair. This is Paul, owner of the Murphy Inn. Our chiming Irish pub features different food and drink specials every day of the week, plus live entertainment every Wednesday through Saturday. The inn even offers 7 unique hotel rooms complete with modern amenities, perfect for overnight stays or a weekend getaway.
There ain't no doubt we're going out to the good old Murphy Inn.
Here we go, 1st and 10, Dragons from the 38-yard line, near side hash mark. 3 receivers wide left, 1 to the right. Presley to the right. Bercy, Henry, and Thompson to the left. Incomplete intended that time for number 3, Takaro Henry. You know, we talk about the size of the schools. Marine City, you know, in the heyday back in the early 2000s, 2007-8, 803-810, down to 512. Clintondale, second and 10 here. Clintondale's 392, and they were as much as 824.
Yeah, I knew they were smaller.
Pass play caught this time by number 23, Thompson. Gets about 9 yards on the play.
Bodie Ramsey, number 68. Tackle there for the Mariners. Yeah, and that with Clintondale school, it's kind of centered, you know, in between some other schools that pull quite a few of the kids out of there. So.
Yep. I've often said to your neighbor across the street, Adam, who's the assistant superintendent at Chippewa Valley, it really does make economic sense. I don't care what anybody says. Take Mount Clemens and Clintondale, fold them into Chippewa Valley.
Yeah.
I mean, they're right down the street. I would think they could offer more services and classes, too. Wide Mariners taking care of this one. Fumble or no?
Well, I think the ball came out, but 51 there for the Mariners. Did a great job, Cole O'Croy, just to make a contact and just driving right through the ball carrier. Backed him up. Makes a long fourth down here for the Clintondale Dragons.
Yeah. Fourth and seven. Fourth and six, I guess. Checking in for the Mariners, Lincoln Osterlin.
Coming off, Kyler Rumley.
Keys takes the snap, going deep. Nice job. Caleb Pelka getting his hands on it. Turnover on downs. Mariners will take over first and 10 from the 42-yard line. Mariners wearing their special orange jerseys tonight, and after the way they played in the first quarter, I was wondering if we'd ever see them again. Lincoln Osterlin at quarterback. Paul Muscat, Cameron Maluski in the backfield. Is that Cooper Letson as well? Looks like it on the near side.
First man through.
Muscat on the carry. Give him about three. Same full house backfield. Second guy through Maluski, cutback, gets a, he's going to be close to a first down if he doesn't have it. Cole O'Croy comes in. Jeremy Westrick comes off. Anthony Ruffino in. Me third and two. Left side. First down easily. Ruffino on a carry.
Yeah, good job getting uphill. You know, that offensive line just gets that little bit of surge in, and once he gets past them, and it's up to him, whichever way he feels, left or right. You know, sometimes it's advantageous to cut across the green, or sometimes it's better just to get that outside edge, get upfield.
Yep. Got an injury timeout at the 9:14 mark, fourth quarter, as you can see there. In case you're joining us late, Dragons dominated the first quarter, and the score at the end of one was?
0-0.
There you go, no score. They dominated the clock. Mariners had a chance to, they were in the red zone twice, fumbled twice. Then in the second quarter, Mariners went and scored two.
Yep, that's correct. Yeah,
missed the extra points.
Yeah, Cooper Letson from 4 yards out, and then the Dragons answered, 6-yard pass as well, so. They converted their two-point conversion. Marine City did not. So that put us at a 6-8 score. And then just before halftime, Heslop connected with Maluski. 1 yard pass. Two-point conversion was no good. So that put us at a 12-8 halftime score.
And then the third quarter belonged to the Mariners, scoring on all their possessions.
We got a flag on the field
here.
Yeah,
they threw a flag during that injury timeout. I don't know what it was.
Maybe it just fell out of his pocket. Oh, sideline warning.
Warning. What was our coach's? Was it, well, too far on the field, I guess? That's the first call of the night that I'll say. I'd shake my head. I don't know. First and 10 from the 32. Near side hash mark, as you see.
First man through. He's through the secondary. Oof, just one guy to beat. Paul Muscat, number two for the Mariners.
Give him about five on the play.
Take it. Clock continues to run.
Second and five from the 27-yard line. Cooper Letson left. Up the gut. Not on that one. Bring up a third and five. Muscat on the carry. Grant Westrick, near side. Keeper by Osterlund, cuts up, gets the first down and a
still
couple more.
Feet.
Yep. Cross to about the 20. First and 10 Mariners. They're going to say from the 20.
And Lincoln did a good job. Yeah. Not, even though he got over the first down, he got the first down, he did a good job of just fighting through, ended up picking up an extra 2 or 3 yards.
I'm impressed for a freshman.
Yeah, he's done very well.
Yeah.
Especially having to come in clutch situations,
right.
You know.
Unbalanced left this time. Hand off Maluski, left side. Sees a little opening. Cut back. Not going to get it this time. Through the whistle.
Way early.
Yeah. Yeah, he's still straight up. Loss of 2, second and 12. Cooper Letson, Grant Westrick, near side.
Fino up the middle. Oh, he's still got some room. He's going to bust it open.
Muscat. Paul Muscat, 22 yards out. I want to see the replay because nobody knew where he was at. We didn't know where he was at.
Yeah, that was a nice little hole. He sidestepped that middle linebacker. Next thing you know, he had all green in front of him.
Is that 22 yards out? Here we go. Wow, he battled right through, didn't he? Paul Muscat earned those yards. Brookman Zuziak for the point after. And it's good. Mariners on top, 40-8. Yeah, you're in the middle of the second quarter, and it was like a deafening silence to the crowd.
Yeah, it was. Yeah,
and all of a sudden, Mariners explode for, you know what, 34 points.
Yeah, coming out of halftime, that's what you want to do. You know, you're getting the ball, you want to go down and make a statement. They ate some clock up, and they just continue to pull away here.
Well, and if you don't make a couple crazy mistakes early.
Yeah, it's a little different.
At least one more touchdown.
Yep.
I'm not going to count the second one. Fielded at about the 15-yard line. This time it's Ja'Cory Bursey run out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. You see it on the scoreboard there. 7:08 left. Mariners on top, 40-8. We are now into week 7. Mariners with a 6-1 record, only a 2-point conversion away from 7-0.
That's right. And a double overtime thriller to open their season here.
from the 38, first and 10. Trips to the left, one to the right. The one to the right is Presley. Delay of game coming off of.
Change of possession?
Yeah. Yeah. Man, that's crazy. First and 15 from the 33.
Like, I could, you know, if you're going to run that program, maybe week one or two, like when you're trying to get things moving, but you're into week seven here
right,
now.
Right.
So.
Hand off left side. Number eight caught from behind.
And number 68 for the Mariners wrapped him up on by the feet. Bodie Ramsey.
Armada leading North Branch.
Oh, wow.
37-20 with 7:44 to go. You know what? 2 weeks ago, people would have told you you're crazy if you would have said that Cross-Lex would have been beat by who, Elmont?
Correct.
Yeah. And now you got Armada on top of North Branch. And, you know, say what you want, good, bad, or ugly, but the BWAC tends to have that beating up on each other.
Sure.
I mean, just when you think one team's got a, you know, chance to lock things up.
Right, it's a lot of back and forth, right?
Yeah.
Don't take anything for granted. They see how much time's left in that game?
No. End of three, Marysville 20, Saints 0. Now there's the band we like to hear.
There it is.
Seven Army Nation. Get the hometown fans into it. Poirier Northern was a tie at halftime with Warren Mott.
I think they're expected to take control of that game pretty easily.
Final Vikings 20, Saints 0. So I'm sure we'll get some more scores there. Second and 12 from the 36. Pass play going deep. Nice job defensively.
That's a great job there in the secondary. That was 88 for the Mariners.
Caleb Pelka.
Yeah.
That was a nice pass, right in the money.
Boy, it was.
He broke it up.
Yeah, he had the two secondary defenders split, basically, and Caleb came over just at the right time and got his hand up and knocked the ball out of the air.
So they'll bring up a third and 12 from the 36. Trips to the near side. Presley along with Thompson and Bercy to the near side, one to the far side. Pass play, going to get taken down at the 22-yard line.
And number 16 for the Mariners. Excellent job wrapping up Cole Smallstig.
Yeah.
Good job. Just got back there, and their routes never developed on that trip side here. They kind of got muddled up. And just didn't allow anything for that quarterback. He knew he was in pressure. He just had nowhere to get rid of it. Ended up tucking it and taking it down.
Says right now that Armada 30, North Branch 20 with 9:46 remaining. So it's a 10-point ball game. Quite a bit of time left. We have 5:43 left. Punt. No return by the Mariners. It'll be somewhere around midfield, right 49-yard line. First and 10, Marine City takes over. So Mariners with a commanding lead here, week number 7. As we talked about, Mariners will be on the road next week at Centerline. Then the following week, in Durand, which we already decided is about an hour and a half drive from East China or Marine City, and it's about, give or take, 20 miles west of Flint off of I-69.
They're the longer road trips we've had for the regular season.
Yep. Lincoln Osterlund looks, passes, no, incomplete. Intended that time. Kyle Rickert, the intended receiver, second and 10. Well, we're hoping that the Mariners are able to get a home playoff game in week 10.
That will begin to take shape the next couple weeks on these on the road games.
In fact, I did see handoff, Maluski left side, gets a couple. So this was snooze to you this week, and they do a pretty good job. It becomes a difficult question of who's going where, because if one team changes, it sends a team north or south. But they had this week Marine City against Pontiac Notre Dame Prep. Winner of that game plays Country Day or St. Clair Shores. Third and nine, Maluski left side. No, I guess not Maluski. Let him know.
I thought he had it too.
Keeper Osterlund. Close, going to bring up a fourth and one.
And I think what's going to change the playoff also is now we're back to the point system this year.
Right.
It's not automatic in.
Right.
And, I mean, a lot of things can happen here in the last couple games of the season.
Oh, sure.
Points, or teams, I think they're going to get points.
Yeah.
Or they win or lose. It'll definitely be a website to watch, that's for sure.
Maluski, no go on that one. Mariners will turn the ball over on downs, and the Dragons will take the ball over with 4:18 remaining in the game. The interesting thing that typically always comes up with Marine City in the playoff time is simply, do we go north, do we go south, depending on who else makes it. This particular scenario has Frankenmuth at the other district at the top end, but then like Armada Richmond in a different district, which you wouldn't think, but it depends how they're paired.
Right.
Because from the map, you look at the map and you go, yeah, that makes sense. But like you say, one team loses a game and boom, that changes everything.
Yeah. That is a good website, though, to follow.
Yeah.
And they're usually
pretty close.
Yeah.
Once in a while, it gets to be just that question of one team going one way or the other.
Yeah, and that screws up your whole logic.
I think last year, Frankenmuth went west. Pass play. Oh, dropped almost it. Caught that by Nequante Thompson, but incomplete. It's just a weird lineup, depending where your teams are coming from. If they send somebody one way, it brings
somebody in from the other way.
Checking in for the Mariners. Got a couple different players. Let's see. Got Xander Cote in. I don't have a 22 here, so.
Yeah, neither do I on my roster.
56, Kaylee Urbani. Pass play, caught this time at number two, Bercy. Bercy picks up about eight on the play.
Tracked down by Caden Martin, number 30 for the Mariners. Bill Westrick, number 99, big defensive nose guard for the Mariners out there as well.
Two to the right, one man in motion this time, number 30, Harnett.
Oh!
Jaden Harnett.
Well, they ran into each other in the backfield.
Don't see that very often.
No, that was they didn't just brush. They kind of hit pretty good there. They had a little confusion there on the Marine City defensive side of the ball. Had what would have been an open receiver here had they been quick on the spot, quick on the snap. But instead, they basically took themselves out in the backfield.
Fourth and five for the Dragons. Trips to the left, two to the right. Keys from the gun, nobody in the backfield. No, I'm sorry, that is not Keys.
Intercepted.
Intercepted.
I think number one, I think that was Grant Westrick that intercepted that.
Not much of a scenario there because it would have been Mariners' ball anyway.
Right.
Fourth down.
And we do got a flag. It's not going to be a personal foul. Some pushing and shoving at the end of the play. So I'm going to say it's personal foul against Clintondale. We tack on an extra 15 yards of that play for the Mariners. And here's the call.
Dead ball, personal foul, White, 15 yards.
There it is.
So positioning would have been the 45. It'll be now on the 30-yard line, far side hash mark. First and 10, Marine City. 2:47 left. You can see at the bottom of our screen, if somebody you know wants to watch the Mariner game but doesn't want to watch it on Channel 6, in case you didn't know, www.watchctv.org. Handoff this time, Maluski left side. But you can watch any game anytime you want. Stop and start it when you want. Right on the website. If somebody's out of town, you can have them go online.
Send them the link, copy and paste it in an email. Yep. Pretty simple.
Yep.
In case you're up at 2 in the morning, Craig, and you want to go back and watch the game or a game, that's a handy resource.
Yep. Mariners in no hurry here. Lincoln Osterlund under center, hands off. No, pass play, throws.
Oh, he's got him open here too.
Oh, just outside the reach.
Trying to connect with number 84 there for the Mariners outside, Colin Gabler.
Trying to get him another pass.
Yeah, it was nice. Just a couple feet out of the reach of Colin. That would have been his second touchdown of the night.
Yep. Gabler along with
Cooper Letson.
Cooper Letson near side. Unbalanced line to the left. First guy threw nothing.
Nothing. Nope. Wrapped
fourth
right up.
Down, yep.
Defensive lineman there for the Dragons.
They'll run this down to about a minute 5 before they punt. Or do they just go for it?
I don't know, man. The way, I mean, if your line can hold the way that they've been getting open on those deep routes, I don't know. Why wouldn't you do that?
Fourth down, 11. Ball spotted on 31. Two-man backfield. Unbalanced left this time. Rolling, Osterlund. Pass play. Oh,
oh
caught,
he caught it.
Caught. Cooper Letson, 20-10. Inside to about the 8-yard line. Extends the play. Yeah. Gets a first down, first and goal with a minute left.
And the drive just kind of had the presence of mind just to stick with it.
Yeah. So the first and goal from the 8. They'll be happy just to sit on it, I would think.
I would think so.
Think they'll take a knee. Three-man backfield. Maluski left side. Yeah, I think he's going to walk in.
Sure
he
is.
He will. Cameron Maluski, 8 yards out. 46-8. Couple amazing things tonight, Jesse. Amazing that the Dragons kept it so close in the first quarter and the first half.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other amazing thing is, as well as the point after is good.
Noah Ross, number 11.
Makes it 47-8. And the other amazing thing is, as well as the Dragons moved the ball in the first half, they did absolutely nothing in the second half.
No, they didn't.
Mariner,
you know, and you saw him trying to get pressured there a little bit, trying to go more to the air, end up throwing,
right.
You know, they have an interception on their last, but they're just not able to do much.
you know, at a 12-8 lead at halftime, it was not too comfortable.
No, not at all. So I'll recap the second half scoring here real quick before they get lined up. So we'll start it off in the third quarter, 7-18. Mariners basically controlled the ball for almost 5 minutes there. Maluski ended up scoring with from 6 yards out. Brooklyn Zuziak added the extra point. That put the Mariners up 19-8. Then shortly after, at 5:26 left in the third, Jeffrey Heslop connected with Aaron Atkinson from 66 yards out for a pass. Ethan Haver added the extra point. Then later on, Colin Gabler from 16 yards out connected from a pass from Jeffrey Heslop. Ella Hensley added the extra point, leaving us with a 33-8 score.
Kick fielded about the 16-yard line. Taking out about the 30, and you can go over the rest of the scoring.
All right, then 22 yards out at 7:14 in the fourth quarter, Paul Mascott put six more on the board for the Mariners. Brooklyn Zuziak added the extra point, resulting in a score of 40-8. Then just now, as you just saw, 28 seconds left here in the fourth from 8 yards out. Maluski ran in for a touchdown for the Mariners. Noah Ross adds the extra point there. Going to end up with our final score here, 47-8. On a homecoming game for the Mariners.
Special thank you to our crew in the trailer, Paul Dingham and Bruce Holiday, Austin Barney, Carter Barney, Ben Stokes, Kenny Young, and Ryan Wiley.
Watching East China High School Sports presented by Magda. Join us again soon for more East China High School sports action on CTV, your community TV channel for Marine City and St. Clair.